presentation. A lot of people hear about the Junior League. They say, I love the Junior League. We've got some fans in here. You say, that's that group that always helps out when somebody needs help. And that is what we do. But we work hard, but we also play hard. So I just put some random photos up of some different things that we have done throughout the past year. And wanted to tell you, you have some flyers on your table, and I hate when people read to me, so I'm not going to read to you. I'm going to highlight the points that you need to remember. One of the big things is this is our first formal announcement. Our signature project has always been Heaven's Law, where we work with Baptists with low-income expectant mothers and mothers of newborns to promote prenatal health, where they go with their checkups, and then they get baptized, and they come to Heaven's Law to get those items that they need, baby wipes, diapers, gently used items, to help them when you got $20 and it's either gas, food, or diapers. We're filling in that gap. We have done that, and we do our impact. The Department of Volunteerism equates 1 hour of volunteerism to $21.36. The ladies in this room have given this economy over $50,000 in volunteer hours, and that is what we do. We are in the midst of new member recruitment. I also challenge you as business owners to allow your employees to become a part of this organization to make a difference. And to also be flexible enough with them when they've got things that is leaked stuff, which I do also at work sometimes, to allow them that flexibility and to give back to the community, because it is about our impact. And partnerships and collaborations, we are really looking for some partners with this early literacy project. We don't even know what it's going to look like yet. We've got some ideas. We've got a leadership retreat tomorrow. And we're going to start putting the rubber to the road to try to figure out how we can make an impact in North Rock. These are some of our sustainers in action. I just thought, I know y'all don't care about them. So. But again, I want to thank you all for allowing us to be here today. And when these ladies contact you, please engage them in some conversation, because I promise you, it'll be worth the effort. Thank you.
This has been 2 years in the making to bring this conference to North Little Rock. It's a very prestigious conference. We were selected over Taiwan, Singapore, and Italy. So it's a huge deal for us, and we couldn't have done that without our community partners, the Argenta Arts Foundation, the Windham Riverfront, and the City of North Little Rock, Mayor Hayes. I mean, we all came together to make sure to showcase our city and what we have to offer. So we're very proud of it coming to North Little Rock. So it's my pleasure to introduce the Dean of the Liberal Arts School at UCA and the Executive Director of the conference, Dr. Maurice.
Doctor, I was there when it was ASTC. Does that count?
That counts.
Okay, all right.
I became the director of this conference in 1994, and I was tricked into it. I was a professor at the University of Northern Iowa, and I was grooming with the head of the English department, and the conference, which had started in 1988 in Paris, was not coming to Iowa because of our life workshop. You know how important that is. So she said, I need a new director for the conference. I said, well, you know, you've got a lot of faculty, a lot of people, public relations. I'm sure that you're willing to do it. She said, no, I think you can do it. I said, no, I have nothing to do about conferences. This is not my job. So she brought out some Godiva chocolates. And we started eating chocolates. And she asked me about 5 minutes later, and I said, Dr. Goldberg, no, I really can't do this. She brought out some 12-year-old scotch. I don't drink scotch. I like bourbon. But we started drinking this scotch, and after about the third drink, I said, well, maybe I can do it. After the fourth drink, unfortunately, I said yes. And I've been doing it ever since. It's a wonderful conference. It started in Paris in 1988. It moved to Iowa in 2000. And since then, it has been in Spain, Portugal, Ireland, and last year it was in Toronto, Canada. It's held every 2 years because I didn't do this every year. I did not expect this conference to be in Arkansas this year. We were really looking at Taiwan, as Hazel said, we were looking at Singapore. And I'm not quite sure who contacted who, but somehow we got together and started talking about it. Skip Rutherford talked about it, and we hosted something at the library. Both the North Little Rock and the Little Rock Business Bureau got together, and they put together a proposal. And I gave it to the board, which consisted of famous writers and scholars, and they liked it. And they said, we're going to Arkansas? I said, yes, but let me tell you something. Arkansas has a lot to offer. And I will tell you this, I'm embarrassed by the fact that I did not know about Northwood.